Today is Sunday, and we're going to playtest Multiverse Cosmic Conquest. And since our last playtest session, we've changed a few things around in the rules. Not anything too big. Mostly, we've just cleaned up some of the corner cases that weren't clear in terms of what happens in certain really specific situations. I'll roll this 20-sided die. It looks like my deck is under your control. So one of the changes that we've done, let's draw 5 cards, let me show you, is that we've brought back the speed stat. So the way that units and structures moved for a while is that they needed to have the flight ability. And if a unit had the flight ability, it could move around in the galaxy. And if a structure had the flight ability, it could also move around in the galaxy, but obviously only if it had a unit inside of it. The way it worked before, okay, that's really strange. The way it worked before then is that we had the speed stat that would determine if a card could move in one turn and how many times it could move. So this card, for example, the Ion Wing, has a speed stat of 2. The way things moved around in the galaxy before this latest change was that if something could move more than once, it explored all the spaces in between where they started the movement, so they would move like one space at a time, therefore exploring a lot of spaces each turn, if they could move a lot of times each turn. And that really helps the expansive strategy, where you need to conquer 10 spaces in the galaxy, a lot more than it does the direct strategy. And that's the opposite of what I wanted to have this speed stamp to do. So an idea came to me, I believe in the shower, on how to make speed work. So now, a card with speed 2 can move onto a space in range 2, essentially, or range 1 as well. And that is one move. So if this were a unit with a speed, I could move it here. And I don't explore any of these two spaces. I just teleported basically there, like you would in Star Trek with the warp drive, or in Star Wars with the hyperdrive, you skip through space. And first of all, that's more realistic, since this is a galaxy, and to travel such huge distances in a galaxy, you need something that warps space. And secondly, it favors gameplay, because with this type of movement, if a structure or a unit has a speed higher than 1, they move faster, but they still only are able to conquer 1 space maximum each turn. Whereas before, they could conquer, like if they had speed 2, they could conquer 2 each turn, speed 3 each turn. So this way, I can first of all, I can more easily make cards with more speed, and I can juggle that number and vary it in order to make the direct strategy more powerful versus the expansive strategy more powerful. Because for a while, the expansive strategy was way, way more powerful than the direct one. And right now, I made this deck kind of to test this new version of movement and how it works. I've upped the speed of certain cards. Maybe the scale is a bit off, but we'll see right now. So let's add the resource at the beginning of our turn. Actually, some other few changes that have been done, more logistical than any other. For example, you add resource not during your beginning of your turn step, but I created a production step in which all of the production of resource occurs simultaneously. So you don't actually need to order the triggers. Since I'm already thinking of an online version, this way is a lot more self-explanatory. Alright, so we have a unit, another unit, a structure, another structure, an action, another structure. So, two units and three structures. Two resource. Okay, so this costs 5. This is not something we're going to play right now. Sabotage. I really have to play sabotage. I think the best thing to do is play... We have a blue unit that costs 1. Sorry. So we'll play this. And we have a red structure that costs 1. This is maybe the best... turn one we could hope for. Put the astronomer into the ship, and it has speed 1, so let's go ahead and explore. Wow, then we got lucky as well. We explored the metal planet, which is maybe the best planet we could have hoped to explore. Okay, at the end of our turn, I may look at one unexplored space in the galaxy and may explore it. Okay, so I'll look at it. And can I place it face down? I think I can do this, right? Yeah. Oh, I don't know what happened. Okay, put it there, and we'll pass the turn. This is a very, very good start for us. The Darn Astronomer will help us move closer to this lava planet and avoid obstacles. Although things like asteroid fields don't hurt us all that much, nebulas do, on the other hand, and we may want to avoid them. Okay. Next turn we'll have control over two spaces. And by the way, this... Oh, no play from our opponent. That's a shame. This deck was built with the direct strategy in mind. And it's looking like our opponent is also going for the direct strategy. Let's draw a card. Okay, we have a 3-cost ship. 2-cost technician. Another structure, sabotage, and frigate. I think the best thing we can do right now is give our ship shields, so we can play this technician here. Put it into... into our bow fighter, and now it has shields. Now we'll go ahead and move there. And we still have 2 resources. I'm not sure if we're going to play anything. No, we can't actually play anything. We could play an iron wing. No reason to right now. We can wait. Let's pass the turn. we didn't make it in time to release the updated rule book onto our website. So we're playing with the new rules, but the rulebook still isn't public. It will be out either today or tomorrow on tokarsmedia.com on our forums section. And it's been really reorganized and made much easier to read. So I encourage you to try it out. I mean, not try it out, to read it and see the differences. And the rules are really, really consistent now. Since we've been changing all of these rules, like modifying them, tweaking the edges here and there, we ended up with these rules that weren't all that consistent. So in some instances, you weren't really sure what would happen. Like but there were some corner cases in which the rules weren't clear on what the protocol was. And now everything is ironed out. I'm just finishing up the multiplayer variants chapter of the rulebook, and it will be out. So you can check it out. I'll post about it on social media as well. Okay, so we have a powerful warship here that can pretty much one-shot us. Yep. The problem is... this is a problem. We do have shields, but even with shields, this doesn't save our ship. And we have a pilot there, so looks like, wow, we lose 3 cards or in exchange of 0. But this, oh, so many. Okay. So this warship has 4 power and quick shot, and can move to space in range 2, so this is in range 2. And for some reason, our opponent spared us this turn. I'll just write saying that you could have attacked my ship and destroyed everything. And speed 2. Alright, so my turn. Let's add some markers. Add some resource. And by the way, you may have noticed that now the empty space is really empty. There is nothing on it. No effect. That's how it was intended to be. And the change in how things move in the galaxy made it possible for removing this extra ability from the empty space. Alright, so we could run away the ship and try to come up with a different plan. So what I'm thinking is I could play this bottom technician that gives an extra +1 shields, which makes our ship survive one attack from our opponent's warship. That sets us back, but since we have two planets, I think we can afford that. We'll play this. 0 and 0. We can actually leave the astronomer on this space here. We don't need it. So this is all on one space. I have 4 resource here. Still, I don't think we need to play anything here. If we end up with a unit next turn by drawing a card, then we could play maybe a frigate and a unit, or one of these ships and a unit, and maybe start exploring the galaxy and try to win that way. That's a good plan B. If not, we will just go forward and try to conquer our opponent's home planet. So we'll see how it goes. I encourage you to check out the new rulebook once it is posted onto our forums in the Multiverse Players sub forum, in the what's the actual section called? Rulebook updates, I think. We've done a whole so the glossary was just a huge wall of text, and now it's a table of contents, basically. We also have a table of contents at the beginning. Everything is well organized. Somebody's screaming outside. So if you're just getting into the game, this is a perfect time. The rules are rock solid. Maybe some of these values, speed, power, and health values will change a little bit, but for the most part, the game is really, really solid. Yeah, here we go. The ship has jumped across this space here. Alright, so our bow fighter has a 3 health and 2 shields. This one has quick shot and a mind bot inside of it, and it isn't affected by nebulas. Alright. I'm kind of afraid of the mind bot, but I think we can. I don't think our opponent understands that we can win. We cannot win a battle against their ship. 3-3. Let's add some resource there. Let's draw a card. Okay, so we didn't draw a unit. That's not really too bad. We can move from here to there and attack. And if I'm correct, I will absorb the first two damage dealt by the Vintoff warship, then it will deal another 2 damage. We will survive. Two damage counters. And at the end of the turn, our shields will be up again. Do we have a ship for 2 resource? We do. We have an Iron Wing. So let's play the Iron Wing here. And let's move. There we go. We don't need to use this astronomer's ability. It's a bit cumbersome. Where did we land? oh, we landed on another metal planet. Oh, that's really... We got really lucky with these metal planets. There are only three in total, or maybe four. Yeah, four metal planets in my galaxy deck. So one is my home planet. I think we've won because with two resource that Devil's Den will be adding this turn, he won't have enough to start defending against so many ships. Okay, so that's a good start. Torpedo. Deal 4 damage to this Iron Wing. Destroying everything here. That's helpful. It's sort of delaying the inevitable a little bit. Another ship. Thankfully, we do have. Two units, so we could conceivably move here. I think that's what I'm going to do. Play. Yeah, this is the only ship we can afford to play, really, right now. Put this there. The end. Pretty good game, actually. Do you have an expensive deck flavor? Okay. I only had time to create this one deck for today. I've been really busy lately. But I'd like to try it out against an expansive deck. Just before we do, look at this card. At the end of our turn, remove a structure in your junkyard from play. And red. Yes, that's true. The text is a big, yes. It's supposed to say from the game. Not from play. What's the card called? Furnace Worker. Okay, I'll fix that. All right, so let's play. Game. Clocking store. Okay. So yeah, mainly the changes that have been done are removing the flight ability and replacing it with the speed stat. It's just easier because it's easier for people to understand. People know what speed is, and it's less text in the rules, it's less text on the card, and it's especially less text if something moves more than once every turn, or it moves faster than something. So if something has speed 2 or speed 3, it's easier than to write, this card can move 2 times on each of your turns on it. So this in this way, you get rid of the extra text on the card as well. Let me center this. Apart from that, yeah, we've fixed the speed and the moving mechanic. It was tilted towards the expansive strategy, but now I feel like it. Oh, that was loud. Okay, let's start. At least now I have a say on which strategy is stronger, just by making the cards faster. Okay, let's take the galaxy deck. Bam. Other than that, I've sort of reworded a lot of things, actually, a bit of the of how things can enter and exit structures, and what inside means. The way it was worded before, it was really hard to understand what you were talking about and how it manifested, this rule manifested itself in gameplay. Now, streamlined the whole process. I'm really satisfied with the result. Doing this the old school way. Okay. I want to see how this deck fares against an expansive strategy. I'd like for the next playtest session to be focused on multiplayer games, but we needed a lot more players for that to be possible. Try to involve as many players as possible, and that's why I've reworked the rulebook as well as created the tutorial series, for it to be easier for new players and playtesters to get into the game. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cards. Let's see what we draw. What we drew. An instant action. Oh, by the way, we renamed the reaction type into instant action because reaction was a bit misleading with what the card. The term reaction was misleading. You kind of think that a reaction can only be played on your opponent's turn. Meanwhile, that's not the case at all. Structure, unit, action. So one unit, which is our droid navigator, isn't affected by asteroid fields. Don't think blue decks use asteroid fields. Actually, they do, so that's not too bad. A bow fighter, not the best hand, okay. So today we're just playing blue and red colors. That's pretty interesting. blue versus red and red blue versus blue. Okay, so we have a play. Fast ship. Fast and weak. Okay, let's add some resource. One red, one blue. Draw a card. Another structure. Okay, we could play this. Our droid navigator costs 3. Bullfighter costs 1. I think if we're going to play the droid navigator, if this card is going to be our unit, then next turn we'll only have one resource left. We're going to play this next turn either way, so if we're going to play something this turn, we're going to play the ship. Or actually nothing. I think we should play nothing, since that leaves us with the most options. Next turn. Could have played the bullfighter, but that doesn't mean that it's our best choice. This is really almost a red card, this stealth flutter. It's speedy and it likes empty spaces. Maybe I could have incorporated into this deck that I'm playing right now. So no units from our opponent, that's unfortunate. Oh wait, it's just the beginning of their turn. Darn Astronomer. That's a card I like. This card has remained exactly the same for such a long time. I really like the design. It's helpful and it's cheap, but it's weak and it's specific. Okay, so we have a really good combination. Oh, that's an interesting deviation from our normal path. Wow, that was lucky. He ended up onto an empty space. So the slugger will be really hard to deal with since it cannot be attacked on empty spaces. That's a new development. Putting that extra 1 speed onto this card really makes it shine. It used to be, I think it used to have shields. That doesn't fit up this particular card. Okay, let's draw a card. Another ship. Okay, so we'll play the droid navigator, since that's our only option at this point. And we'll play the truck bull fighter, because again, that's our only option at this point. And we want to start exploring galaxy, or better yet, okay, so wait, this thing can move only once per turn. Okay, let's reveal this, move there. That's not too bad, actually. The ocean planet can be of help to us. Alright, when the droid navigator is in a ship, that ship isn't affected by asteroid fields. This is helpful. Okay, so this fighter cannot do much against the lugger. The lugger will be able to attack us, but it's going to die if it does. So we're not exactly afraid of it. The thing is that it's going to be hard to deal with, because since it has 2 speed, it can easily get to an empty space, especially if it's explored, like this one. And we'll have to see if our opponent moves closer to us or stays at this safe range 2 distance. Yep, looks like it is staying at this distance. Ooh, that's really interesting. Okay. This changes the game quite a bit. A card like Electrical Disruption could help us in the future. Or we could play... Do we have any units? We don't. Oh, that's bad. Okay, it's our turn. Let's add the resource. Unfortunately, we do not have cargo ships in this deck. So this extra two blue resource probably won't help us. We could play Sabotage, but it only works in range one. And it's not an instant action, okay. This card also works in range one, but it is an instant action. So technically, we could play this in response to our opponent conquering our home space, but that doesn't help us in any way. Sabotage also wouldn't help us. So, what we can do is, since we don't have any units, we have to do this. And now we have the ability to play either Sabotage or Electrical Disruption from this space here, or we could even play another ship. We could play an Iron Wing. It has Pierce. We could put the Droid Navigator into the Iron Wing, move the Iron Wing here, and I don't think I'm prepared to do this. Yeah. We could have self-destructed by battling against the Stealth Logger. At this point, we have two planets under our control. Maybe that was the right thing to do, since we don't have any other units. That's a tough call. No, actually, I think I was wrong now. Yeah, I needed to... No, but then I wouldn't have any units. I need to value these units. That's tough. You know what? Yeah, I think it's not too bad, since by next turn we'll gain another two resource, and we'll be able to play this other ship with two speed, and this one doesn't have to fear anything from the Stealth Logger. So that actually was the right decision after all. Yeah, we'll be able to play this Light Vintage Warship. Maybe a bit overpowered, actually. I could easily make it 2-3-3 quick shot. I added the extra power because most ships now are stronger than they were before the change, before the changes. Some of these power and health stats aren't final. We'll see what our opponent does. Takes control of the card. Ooh, wow, that's interesting. So I see his plan. So I think he plans on conquering 10 spaces in the galaxy. That's what I'm seeing here. Choose any. Instruction range one at the end of the turn. Now it's in range of Sabotage. and electrical disruption. Any one structure in one can battle or move this germ. Oh no! Whenever an opponent draws a card, draw a card. Whenever an opponent plays a card, oh, this is way really bad for us. So we can't destroy this thing while it's on an empty space, so the Light Wind of Warship doesn't help us in that regard. We could play Sabotage and wait it out. I think... Oh, actually, let's add the resource and draw a card and see what we draw. Frigate. That's good. Not now, though. Sabotage. I think we have to play Sabotage, and we'll play it from here, since not much else we can do there. We'll play Sabotage. And at the end of its controller's turn, destroy it. So next turn, at the end of Devil's Den's turn, it will be destroyed. Not right now. And we have 4 resources on our home planet. We could play a ship. Unfortunately, that's not going to help us. Actually, okay. Whenever an opponent plays a card, you may play a card with the same cost for free from your hand onto the same space. Okay. So, I sabotage your ship. You can play a card with the same cost. You can play a card costs 2 onto this space. The ocean planet. Your ship will be destroyed at the end of your next turn. We're in a bad shape. This Encephal, Queen Encephal, is really powerful. What can we do against this? Well, what we really can do is play a fast ship and get there and destroy it. Won't happen. I'm sorry. This won't happen at the same. Like, it won't happen in one turn. Okay. Anyone structure in range 1 can battle or move this turn. Okay, so our fighter can battle or move this turn. That's good. That we weren't planning on doing that anyway. In fact, there was a really bad card to play here. He would have played a unit and gained control of this space. And maybe played something. Okay. Okay, so this can't move or battle this turn. We can still play something. I think we should still play the Vintoff Warship. Okay, this can't battle this turn. Take that. This wasn't necessary, but at least it means that he'll leave us alone on this space. I won't self-destruct against this warship. He can do 2 damage to our fighter, which is what he could have done before anyway, but I don't want to risk losing the game, so this is more of a precaution. You never know, maybe he has something up his sleeve. Yeah, so he could continue to jump from space to space, one space to another. Well, fortunately, the lugger can... You can say goodbye to the lugger. It's going to be destroyed at the end of the turn. Distracting me. Okay, so reveals empty space and turns on upright. Okay, yeah, he evacuated his lugger. Makes sense. And probably he'll get rid of the. I mean, he still hasn't added any resource here. He could have played something there. Could have played something on his home planet. He's not doing... He's forgetting to add a resource. It's getting really complex. I like it. I mean, the rules have been simplified and streamlined, but the gameplay now is more compelling. That's the best of both worlds. So by the way, when a unit isn't inside of a structure, it doesn't die now. There was a rule that said that a unit can only survive when it's outside of a structure on planets. That's not a rule anymore. It adds another element to battle. Like, now you can decide to have a unit evacuate a structure and attack a structure your opponent's control on the same space. Or you can have a unit stranded in empty space, like has happened here, which is pretty cool. And, I mean, everything is so technologically advanced, it doesn't make any sense why a unit cannot survive in space. I mean, they can have a, what's it called, a space suit. Okay, so I think we're pretty well set here. This is still ours. This is ours. Draw a card. We could play a pilot, and we'll make this warship unaffected by asteroid fields and nebulas, but I don't think that's needed because, I mean, it has speed 2. We can just jump here and jump here. But we'll play a pilot anyway. We'll play a pilot there. Just so we have something on our homes, home planet. We'll put this in front, this there. We'll jump here. This will defend our base in case something weird happens. Nothing is going to happen here, but our opponent can easily play a card there. And wing, electrical team frigate. Okay, that's going to be it for our turn. We're almost there. It's pretty cool though, this Vint of Warship can now move on to any space in the galaxy. Since it's in the center and it has speed 2. I like it. It won't be able to win the game next turn since the Queen Encephal has 6 health. Also, Devil's Den has been forgetting to draw all these cards. I would have lost a long time ago if he wasn't so forgetful. I'll remind him off stream. Read the card is maybe the most important rule in any trading card game. So what's happening? Why do we have 10 resources here? So, do we have play from our opponent? Do we? Come on. I'm about to win the game. What else can I talk about? Yeah, it's you can see it's really fun to play the game. And it's been really fun for a long time now. Remember, the first playtest sessions were cringy, the game wouldn't work, and maybe would be fun for 10% of the gameplay, but now it's constantly engaging, and it's been that way for months, and this latest change only fixes these little problems that would sometimes happen on the edges of the rules, and makes everything consistent. Also, the rules themselves have become easier to understand for new players. Like having the speed stat really is more intuitive than having the flight ability. And how battles work, how resources is made, all of these things haven't really changed all that much. I mean, it's still the same game. It's just worded in a way that it's easier to comprehend. Oh, so no plays, huh? It's looking really bad. Strong card. Okay, let's go here. damage. Right, and this one has 4 damage. Well, that wasn't the best thing I did all day. Still don't have another unit. I don't want to risk moving from our home planet somewhere else, since I know that our opponent has ships with 2 speed that can get from here to our home planet. Could just play it and win the game right then and there. I don't have any reactions that would stop that. Actually, electrical disruption, the way it's worded, doesn't work all that well with the new rules, so I'll put here fix furnace worker, which was a card that needed to be fixed, and electrical disruption. Actually, I still have to do a couple of changes to the new card set. Most of them have been done, but a few things I forgot. Okay, so what do we have here? Okay, he added 4 damage to his queen. I'll just write to him and say, draws a card, draw a card, so yeah. What is... Oh, he has a frigate here. Well, that's pretty bad. He can actually move away from... Oh, no, he cannot. He has to attack us here. And I believe he's going to... We'll deal 4 damage to the frigate, and then it will deal 4 damage to us. Destroying the warship and the navigator droid. Man, this has been a really heated battle. So this turn frigate has 1 health remaining though. I don't think he read our previous message about the Queen and Cephal. That's really the only reason we're still in this game, although we're kind of not anymore. We need a unit. We can't really play without units. There we go. What's this? Ship that cannot be attacked or boarded as long as it's on an empty space. So, it's really close to the lugger. Weird. They need to be changed then. Okay, Tyrum, lugger, and Burdock. That's not what I intended. Are too similar. one speed, though. So, what will he do with it? Oh, he won't do much. We need a unit. Without the extra unit, I don't feel comfortable. Okay, so this thing isn't affected by nebulous, so it will continue moving on. Our opponent is playing really slowly. I'm sorry about that. But it's okay. We've just updated the rules, and they're still unfamiliar to this guy. But I think I'll lose this game. If I play, say, a Terran Frigate here and get away from my home planet, then I guess I could do something. But I think I'll be overwhelmed in a short while. If I don't draw a unit, I'll call it quits. Let's just concede. This is painful to watch. Played a Barm Technician, giving his ship shields 1. Okay, so we can deal with this, actually. That's not what I wanted. Okay, we will... go here, play a frigate, and we can't have much more over there. Oh, it cannot be attacked or boarded on empty spaces. Oh, I'm dumb. Move back then. Wait a second. I think I have to move back then. Electrical disruption, speed burst. Is this really the only thing I can do? I think that's it, yeah. Power 5 health. This one has 4 power 2 health. Plus shields. So 5 power has, 4 power 3 health, essentially. We still win this fight. Though he can, oh no, he can, if he sees this line, he'll win. If he sees that he can get rid of his droid navigator, like he moves here, gets rid of his droid navigator, makes him exit the structure, attacks with the... wait a second. With the ship first. No, that doesn't work. Forget it. It doesn't work. I thought that he could destroy our frigate, and he could, by attacking with the ship and the unit, but then both of the units would be destroyed. So that means that my home planet still remains under my control. Although, one thing that he can do is he can have a unit of his exit his structure on this space, yeah, and gain control of my fighter. And then do something with the resource, maybe. How much resource is there? Think I'm cornered. So this thing can move once per turn, right? If I play Iron Wing, a speed burst, that doesn't get me there. I need another speed burst. This thing costs two. If I have two speed bursts, I can win. So if the card I draw next turn is a speed burst, then I win the game by just jumping all the way here. By the way, I have to reword. Okay, so we're almost done here. The suffering is almost over. Devil's Den takes control of Torquebo Fighter, so now he gains control of my ship. He could technically move with it. Maybe he'll move out of the way, since my frigate can attack from range 1, or he can move closer and attack us. That's probably going to be better. Yeah, thought so. Wait, this isn't right. That also doesn't work, by the way. If he attacks my frigate, I deal 4 power, 4 damage to the cloaked ship, 4 damage to the bow fighter. He loses everything, and I lose everything. So I would still be not dead. Because I deal 4 damage every time I battle. And there is no such thing as ganging up with 2 units onto one, like 2 objects onto one object. Okay, so he's trying to sabotage. Okay. Wait me out. That's really good, actually. Okay. 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 Next turn, this will blow up. So, let's see if he attacks my ship. He can still attack it with the bullfighter. I'm still losing, but I can survive a couple of turns still, I think. If he continues to ignore the things written on Queen and Sappho. I mean, this game would have been long, long over. Devil's Den takes control of this card. Okay, sure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Does he realize that he's won the game? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And that's still 9. What he's doing? Just explore another space. What did he just explore? Yeah, he did. Okay, that's 10.
Wait a second. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's... Congratulations, Devils, then you won. Man, what a long and drawn-out battle. I'll talk to him offline about the Queen Encephal. Read your cards. Read the text on the cards. That really helps you out. On a side note, Queen Encephal is probably overpowered still. One. Okay then, thanks everybody for watching. I've learned a few things today, and most importantly, I know that these updated rules work better than the ones that were before. I really like the way speed is implemented. Thanks everybody for watching, and I'll see you guys next week. Please join these test sessions. It's getting incredibly fun. I don't know where Gamek 1 was. Hopefully he'll come back. And all of you as well. I'll post this on YouTube. Thanks for watching. Keep it up. See ya.